Do you think the machine will ever be finished?
I thought about that already. I think there are two scenarios. Whether it will be finished this decade, or it will be never finished.
Finished this decade. Love it. Love the optimism.
Welcome to Wintergatan Wednesdays and day 4 of the Marvel Machine X completion race. In order to be able to perform really high precision timing tests of the music of the Marvel Machine X, we're attaching an electric motor to the powertrain. I'm gonna start today by trying to attach this 3D printed pulley by AlexCNC to the machine itself. When I disassembled these pieces, I was smart enough to number them, so now I know in which order they go onto the shaft. I'm gonna start backwards with number 5. Indexable clutch by machine thinking. This big gear can shift to the side to allow the smaller gear to slide in. A collet by Tim Mitchell. Probably this is more like a sleeve. And vibraphone vibrato pulley shaft, also by Tim Mitchell. Goes into the sleeve and screws into the shaft. Then I can lock it down further with these screws. Beautifully over-engineered.
My name is Alex and I'm already quite long in the MMX team, I think. I'm mostly doing stuff in the background, like ordering stuff for Martin and helping him with some knowledge I have, and also making parts for him, like the conveyor belt, lift acrylic parts. And Martin asked for something to test the timing of the machine, and for that he has to crank it at a constant speed and repeatable at a constant speed. So I thought about how to solve that.
Since the electric motor is an afterthought, we have no designated place to attach these pulleys. But Alex came up with the idea that we can attach it right here somewhere. I think this makes a lot of sense. So we're gonna use these screw holes to key the pulley. And now I'm going to make a plywood insert for this 3D printed pulley. Every time I want to make something on the CNC machine, I first have to design it in CAD, then I have to make the toolpaths, I have to export a G-code, then clean up the work surface of the CNC machine every time, then I have to set up the stock material and cut the parts, and when the parts are cut, I have to clean the parts, and then I'm ready for assembling them. I nailed the outside diameter. This snaps in perfectly, but I failed here. This is too big. I'm gonna recut that. That works great. And now, both of them. Yes. Once again, I've used my favorite technique to cut the design in the middle, and I've made these 3 grooves. And these are pre-drills for taps, because I want to hit exactly these 3 M6 threads in the metal part. And as you can see when I'm spinning around, these grooves are pointing perfectly at the center of those. So when I take the other part and I close it together like this, I have perfect pre-drill channels in the plywood. It would have been very difficult to drill these accurately afterwards, for me at least. I don't have that kind of equipment. And I also super nailed the fit here. As you can see, sliding with some resistance. Perfect. If I've done everything correctly now, this should be quite plug and play here. So one of these 3 screws goes into the keying here, which will completely lock it in place. Rock solid. 2020 finish. Perfect. So step one is completed, the pulleys on, and even though I was really efficient and worked focusedly, this took half a day to get this to this position. So things take time. Next step, put the motor mount somewhere here. It's a perfect press fit first try. Listen to this. When it makes a kind of whale communication sound, then you know you nailed it. We have the motor mount, now we have to mount this onto the machine itself. So I clamp the board onto the legs and I put the motor mount over here. And I can kind of see that the belt is working something like this. But we ordered the wrong belt. We ordered an open one and we have a closed one coming, but it's not here yet. So I am going to try to stitch together this open belt somehow. Might work. All right. Brilliant. It already plays music by itself. Now I can tension the belt a little bit with this clamp here. We have a connection. This is a better way. I put an M8 bolt here and I can now pivot the motor on this pivot point like this. And as you can see, the belt is getting tensioned. Lock it in place. Et voila. I have to figure out these electronics now. And mount them here. Electronics is my maker kryptonite. So I'm so happy that Alex CNC just made this so plug and play for me. And we're actually good to go. What is going to happen now? I have to read the instructions from Alex.
I used a brushless DC motor, which is commonly used in RC models and so on, to RC cars, planes, helicopters. And so, yeah, that's also quite suited for the marble machine to drive it because it has enough power, it's easy to use. Yeah, even Martin was able to use it instantly, so.
Power on and wait 10 seconds. I heard something. I think that's a good sign. The knob sets the level of support that is not regulated. It only helps cranking the machine. When the switch is enabled, the speed will be held. Okay. So up with the knob a little bit. Whoa! It scared me.
The parts I sent Martin, I had used in an earlier project of mine. It was an electric longboard where I can just stand on the longboard, pull a trigger, and then it goes forward. Yeah, I think it works pretty well. I also showed him how to set the speed directly so he can say, wants to play in 120 BPMs, then he can set the motor to the right RPM.
What is sounding? Oh, stop. The belt was eating its way into the gear. Apart from that, so successful first try. I have to understand more about how the motor works, but this was amazing. So the only issue we had was that the belt was climbing to the side and starting to fall off this pulley. I'm gonna build two flanges here to keep the belt on the pulley. Change of plans, the new belt just arrived and it's much shorter than the first one. So I'm gonna move the motor up here and maybe with this shorter belt we don't need any flanges. So I can skip that step. Having the motor up here also give me access to the controller here, like from the crank. I can even crank and modify the helper at the same time. Okay, second setup ready. Motor is here, belt is tensioning, it looks like it can track. And now I have access to the controller here while cranking. Wow. Look, this just works. And if I now speed up, and now I'm gonna try the governor. Okay, now we're on the governor. This is amazing. So now I can switch to the helper. Nothing happens with the tempo. I reduce the amount of help. So if I want to play myself, I have help now, like a bike engine. Timing test, governor. Let's listen to the hi-hat. This in the computer. Alex said that I can break the machine. Wow. So the motor is going, it's trying, but I can break, and then or like this. That's unbelievable. I'm so proud of myself that I got this up and working in one day. I mean, this is so cool. I can just, the motor is actually on, so I can just start the machine. And it will keep that tempo if I wanted to go faster. It keeps that tempo. And the belt is tracking beautifully. No problem there. Governor. No hands. Stage dive mode. And I'm allowed to break it and the motor doesn't break. So cool. The reason that I could get all this done in one single workday is because of my improved focus that I've been working so hard. And the fact that I have a larger team which enables me to focus like this. So thank you everyone who are supporting this project through Patreon and YouTube memberships and from buying the merch. Everyone who bought the I Believe t-shirt and the I Believe merch, thank you so much. It is thanks to you that I have the possibility to focus like this and that I have learned to do that. I can actually cross out a whole thing on my to-do list. Hookup motor is crossed out from only one day's of work. Tomorrow I will start on the precision timing tests and that's going to be for next episode. I'm gonna record the audio and measure the BPM and we will get very exact results on how tight this machine actually can play. I can't be happier than today's progress. Thank you so much for watching. See you on the next Wintergatan Focused Wednesday.